Welcome, my dear learners, for this course on heat transfer. In this module 4, we were discussing on convective heat transfer. In our previous lecture, we have discussed the basics of convective heat transfer and also we have conducted the dimensional analysis for free convection as well as for forced convection heat transfer. In today's lecture, we are beginning solving numerical problems on forced convection. Under forced convection, we will be discussing numerical problems on flow over a flat plate, flow across cylinders, flow across spheres, and also finally internal flow, that is flow through ducts of circular cross section. First, let us discuss numerical problems on flow over a flat plate in today's lecture. Now, to solve problems in forced convection, we have a standard procedure that first determine the film temperature, which is given in page number 113 of our heat transfer data handbook written by C.P. Kothandaraman. We are referring 8th edition to discuss various topics in this heat transfer course. So referring to our heat and mass transfer data handbook written by C.P. Kothandaraman, in 8th edition, referring to page number 112, we have all the dimensionless numbers. Page number 113 onwards, we have correlation for external flows, that is for flow over a flat plate. There itself he has given the formula for film temperature. Find out the film temperature. At film temperature, for the fluid what you are using for heating or cooling the medium, you should note down the various properties of the working fluid. For air or for water, we have from the design data handbook the various properties. Once at the film temperature, if you note down the various properties of the working fluid, then find the Reynolds number. So once you determine the Reynolds number, based on the value of Reynolds number, we will detect whether the flow is laminar or turbulent. Depending on the flow, whether it is laminar or turbulent, from page number 113 onwards, we have correlations for local Nusselt number. Once you determine the local Nusselt number for flow over a flat plate, the average Nusselt number is equal to 2 times the local Nusselt number. So once you obtain the average Nusselt number, I can find the average heat transfer coefficient. Using average heat transfer coefficient, I can determine what is the rate of heat transfer by using Newton's law of cooling. Come, let us solve the numerical problems. The problem number 1 states that in a certain glass making process, a square plate of glass 1 meter square area and 3 mm thick heated uniformly to 90 degrees Celsius. So therefore, it has a constant wall temperature heated uniformly to 90 degrees Celsius. Is cooled by air at 20 degrees Celsius flowing over both sides parallel to the plate at 2 meters per second, calculate the initial rate of cooling the plate. Take for glass density as 2500 kg per meter cube and specific heat as 0.67 kilojoules per kgK. If I list out the data given for problem number 1 of our discussion, the problem is like this. We have a square plate. Let me draw an isometric view for better understanding. If I draw an isometric view, we have a square plate of one meter square area and we have specified the thickness for us so we have a glass plate like this which is heated uniformly by blowing an air on both sides. On both sides, the air is flowing over the surface. Now we have the surface temperature which is maintained at constant and we have the ambient air temperature given for us. And he has also specified the thickness. The thickness is also specified. The thickness of this is specified as 3 mm. 3 mm thick. Now the area is also known to us. Area is 1 meter square and the surface temperature is 90 degrees Celsius. Ambient air temperature is given for us which is 20 degrees Celsius and is cooled on both sides. The velocity of air, it is noted by U, which is 2 meter square. Second, calculate the rate of cooling, that is change in temperature with respect to time, and we have density of glass, density of medium is 2500 kg per meter cube, and the specific heat of glass is 0.67 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. So this is the data given. Now if I move for solution, as I said, directly go to page number 112. From 113 onwards we have correlation for forced convection, we are dealing with flow over a flat plate. So therefore if we take the data handbook, that is heat and mass transfer data handbook written by C.P. Kothandaraman, we are referring 8th edition, in page number 113 itself he has given for external flow properties are to be evaluated at film temperature, where the film temperature TF is given by the formula wall temperature plus ambient air temperature or ambient fluid temperature divided by 2. So this is referring to page number 113. This is referring to page 113 of data handbook. Now I can calculate the film temperature of the working fluid. The wall temperature is 90 and the surface temperature itself is called as wall temperature here, and the ambient air temperature is 20. 90 plus 20 is 110. 110 by 2 is 55 degrees Celsius. Now at 55 degrees Celsius, from page number for air, we have the correlations at the page number 34 itself, we have the property values for gases, that is for dry air. At page number 34, the properties of air, the properties of air are, so we know the property for 50 degrees Celsius and 60 degrees Celsius. So therefore for 55 degrees Celsius I should take the average values. So if I take the average values, first one is density, so density is turning out to be 1.093 plus 1.060 divided by 2. So therefore density of air will be 1.0765. Next we have absolute viscosity mu. Absolute viscosity will be 19.61 plus 20.10 divided by 2, which is 19.855 into 10 to the power of minus 6. And next we have kinematic viscosity, which we can determine directly, no need to go for average, it is mu by rho, which we know already. Next we have thermal diffusivity alpha, Prandtl number PR, specific heat CP, and thermal conductivity K. Coming for thermal diffusivity, it will be 25.722 plus 27.194 divided by 2, which is 26.458. Next, coming for Prandtl number, the 0.698 plus 0.696, average is 0.697. Coming for the value of CP, it is 1005, and the thermal conductivity will be 0.02826 plus 0.02896 divided by 2, which is 0.02861. So these are the properties that we have taken from page number. So these are the properties that we have taken from page number 34 for dry air, because the fluid what we are employing is dry air. So if I calculate the kinematic viscosity, it will turn out to be 19.855 divided by 1.0765, that is 18.444 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Coming for units, density is kg per meter cube, u is Pascal second, kinematic viscosity meter square per second, thermal diffusivity is also meter square per second, Prandtl number dimensionless, this is joules per kg K, and this is watt per meter Kelvin. So I noted down all the values at film temperature, that is at 55 degrees Celsius, because water temperature is 90, ambient temperature is 20, the sum is 110 divided by 2 is 55. We have the properties at 50 and 60, I have taken the average value for 55 degrees Celsius. So now I can solve this problem. First step is to find the Reynolds number. Find the Reynolds number. Reynolds number Re is equal to rho u L by mu. This is from page 112 of our design data handbook. So if we calculate the Reynolds number, we have the density of air as 1.0765 into velocity is 2 meters per second into flow over a length of 1 meter by mu is 19.855 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So if I solve, I will get the Reynolds number as 108436.162. So therefore, if I solve by using data handbook from page number 113, for constant wall temperature the flow is laminar for Reynolds number less than 5 into 10 to the power of 5. In terms of 10 to the power of 5, if I write this one, so this will become, Reynolds number will become in terms of 10 to the power of 5 as 1.08436 into 10 to the power of 5. So for Reynolds number less than 5 into 10 to the power of 5, the flow is laminar. Since Re is less than 5 into 10 to the power of 5, flow is laminar from page number 113 of heat and mass transfer data handbook. Now for constant wall temperature with laminar flow, we have equation 1.1 from the same page, that is nux is equal to 0.332 rex to the power of 0.5 and pr to the power of 0.333. So we have calculated for the overall length. For the overall length, the flow is laminar itself, and this formula is for local Nusselt number. Kindly make a note. This is for local Nusselt number. Now we know what is the value of Reynolds number. We know what is the value of Prandtl number. I can find local Nusselt number. So therefore, the local Nusselt number will be local Nusselt number nux is equal to 0.332 into Reynolds number is 108436.1622 whole to the power of half. Prandtl number is 0.697 to the power of 1/3. So therefore I will get the local Nusselt number as local Nusselt number will be 0.332 into 108436.1622 whole to the power of 1 by 2 into Prandtl number is 0.697 to the power of 1/3. So the local Nusselt number is 96.932. So therefore average Nusselt number Nu is equal to 2 times the local Nusselt number. This you people should know for flow over flat plates. Whereas for flow across a cylinder and flow across a sphere, directly we get the average Nusselt number and directly we can solve based on diameter. Only for flow over a flat plates, first we should calculate the local Nusselt number and then you should calculate the average Nusselt number. Based on average Nusselt number, you should solve the problem. So now, if I solve, I will get the average Nusselt number as 2 times the answer, which is 193.865. So now from page number 112 of data handbook, we know that Nusselt number is given by HL by K. So therefore I can find the value of H. H is equal to Nusselt number is 193.865, thermal conductivity is 0.02861 divided by length is 1 meter. So hence convective transfer coefficient for this problem will be Nusselt number into 0.02861 divided by 1, that is 5.546 watt per meter square Kelvin. So hence we can find the rate of heat transfer as rate of heat transfer by convection from Newton's law of cooling. We know that Q is equal to HCA surface area, wall temperature minus ambient temperature. So rate of heat transfer will be surface area is 1 meter square, but he is asking us to take the both the sides. So therefore I should multiply it by 2. Multiplied by 2 into HAS by T bar minus T infinity. This 2 is because both sides. We should solve for both sides. Hence Q will be 2 times H is 5.546 into area is 1 into temperature difference is 90 minus 20, which is turning out to be 776.44 watts. So now to find rate of cooling, we know that for rate of cooling we have heat lost by plate, heat lost by glass plate is given by Q is equal to MCP dT by dT. He is asking the rate of cooling, but I don't know the mass of glass, but I know that mass of glass is given by mass of glass is equal to density times volume. We know density. Density of glass is 2500 into volume is area into length. Area is 1 meter and thickness is 3 mm. So that is 3 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meters. So therefore I have calculated by using the formula mass is equal to density into volume, where volume is area into thickness. That is 2500 into 1 into 3 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So mass of glass is 7.5 kg. So we know what is heat loss, that is 776.44 watts, mass is 7.5 kg, CP of glass is given 0.67 into 10 to the power of 3, 0.67 into 10 to the power of 3 joules divided by dT by dt. So therefore, rate of cooling, rate of change of temperature with respect to time will become 776.44 divided by 7.5 into 0.67 into 10 to the power of 3 joules per kgK, which is 0.1545. The answer is 0.1545 degree Celsius per second. So the rate of cooling is 0.1545 degree Celsius per second. For 1 second, there is a temperature drop of 0.1545 degree Celsius. So this is the solution for problem number 1. Let me pause this video for a while so that you people can copy it down. Later we'll solve problem number 2. Now moving ahead, the problem number 2 states that air at 30 degrees Celsius flows with a velocity of 2.8 meters per second over a plate of 1 meter long, 0.6 meter wide and 0.025 meters thick. The top surface of the plate is maintained at 90 degrees Celsius if the thermal conductivity of the plate material is 25 watt per meter degree Celsius. Calculate heat loss by the plate, bottom temperature of the plate for the steady state conduction. Let me list out the data given and analyze what needs to be done for the given problem. We have a plate of 1 meter long and thickness is specified. Let me draw an isometric view for better understanding. We have width as 0.6 meters whereas length is 1 meter and thickness is 0.025 meters. So we have a problem like this. Now there is a flow happening over this plate and I want to find the bottom temperature. So therefore, let us fix the bottom. He has not specified heat transfer takes place from both the surfaces. Since he is asking to find the bottom temperature, I can't use heat transfer by both sides. Now the entire top surface is maintained at 90 degrees Celsius, so therefore we have constant wall temperature. So we have a constant wall temperature of 90 degrees Celsius, whereas the working fluid is air, which is at 30 degrees Celsius, and we have the length. Length is specified for us. Length is 1 meter and width is 0.6 meter and thickness is 0.025 meters. And he has given the velocity as 2.8 meter per second and this is the hint for us. This is problem is a forced convection problem. Velocity specified, or you should specify the mass flow rate. If I know mass flow rate, then I can use the formula from continuity equation, m dot is equal to rho AV. So if I know density and area of the flowing fluid, then I can determine what is the velocity of the flowing fluid. This type of approach will be used for flow inside a circular duct. When I take internal flows, you will get the better understanding about how to determine velocity. When velocity is missing, mass flow rate is given. Moving ahead, yes, given the data as air temperature is given, volume is specified, wall temperature is specified, then he has given the thermal conductivity of plate, very important. Thermal conductivity of plate is 25 watt per meter degree Celsius. Now, you know, to solve this problem, so we have the standard approach. First, at the film temperature, I want to list out the
properties of working fluid.
Now from page number 113, properties. Here the working fluid is air. Properties are of air are to be evaluated at film temperature, where he has given the formula for film temperature as wall temperature plus fluid temperature by 2. Hence the wall temperature and fluid temperature average will be 90 plus 30 by 2, which is 60. Thank God for 60 we have directly the properties, 60 degrees Celsius. Now for air you should refer page number 34. The additional information I will give you for water. For water as a working fluid you refer page number 22, and for engine oil, if you are using engine oil, refer page number 25 for the properties. Now here the working fluid is air. For air, referring to page number 34, at 60 degrees Celsius, note down all the properties. Now moving to data handbook, at page number 34, at 60 degrees Celsius, we have density of air is 1.06, absolute viscosity is 20.1 into 10 to the power of minus 6, kinematic viscosity is 18.97 into 10 to the power of minus 6, thermal diffusivity alpha is 27.194 into 10 to the power of minus 6, PR, Prandtl number at 60 degrees Celsius is 0.696, and then we have CP, specific heat at 60 degrees Celsius is 1005, and thermal conductivity of air at 60 degrees Celsius is 0.02896. So we got all the properties coming for units. This is kg per meter cube, this is pascal second, this is meter square per second, thermal diffusivity square per second itself, Prandtl number is dimensionless, Cp is joules per kg Kelvin, thermal conductivity is watt per meter Kelvin. Now we know all the properties. First I should find out the Reynolds number to check whether the flow is laminar or turbulent. Now we know that Reynolds number is given by rho u L by mu. This is from page number 112. So Reynolds number will be, we have the density as 1.06 into velocity is 2.8 into length is 1 meter divided by mu. Mu is 20.1 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Therefore Reynolds number is turning out to be 147661.69. So I want to express it in 10 to the power of 5. It is 1.47662 into 10 to the power of 5. So since Re is less than 5 into 10 to the power of 5, the flow is laminar. The flow is laminar. So this is from page number 113. So therefore, from same page number, we have the formula for local Nusselt number. Go for directly to page number 113. So if I move for page number 113, we have for constant wall temperature, for laminar flow, we have local Nusselt number, NUX for constant wall temperature as 0.332 Rex to the power of 0.5 Pr to the power of 0.333. Now we know all the values. Calculate the answer for local Nusselt number. So therefore, local Nusselt number is equal to 0.332. Reynolds number is 147,661.69 whole to the power of 1/2 into Prandtl number is 0.696 whole to the power of 1/3. So hence the local Nusselt number for this problem will be 0.332 into 147,662 whole to the power of 1/2 into 0.696 to the power of 1/3. So I got the local Nusselt number as 113.06. So therefore, average Nusselt number for flow over a flat plate, I should use average Nusselt number. So average Nusselt number nu is equal to 2 times the local Nusselt number nu x, only for flow over a flat plate. So this is multiplied by 2, which is 226.12. So now I know that Nusselt number nu is equal to hl by k. This is from page number 112. So find the value of h. H is equal to Nusselt number is 226.12 into thermal conductivity of air is 0.02896 divided by, the flow is over a length of 1 meter. So therefore, convective heat transfer coefficient is answer times 0.02896 divided by 1. That is 6.548 watts per meter square Kelvin. Now we know that rate of heat transfer Q from Newton's law of cooling is given by HAS delta T, that is wall temperature minus ambient air temperature. So rate of heat transfer will become 6.548 into surface area. Surface area is this length into this length, that is 1 meter into 0.6, 1 into 0.6, and temperature difference, wall temperature is 90, ambient air temperature is 30. So hence the rate of heat transfer will be h into 1 into 0.6 into 90 minus 30 is 60. So rate of heat transfer is 235.74 watts. So I calculate the rate of heat transfer, which is 235.74 watts. Now he is asking us to calculate the bottom temperature. So now to find the bottom temperature, the heat will propagate from bottom to top, correct? Because we have the gradient in the top surface, because heat is rejected from top surface. So therefore, heat is conducted in this direction. So this is direction for Q conduction. Q conduction. Hence, we know that to find bottom temperature, to find bottom temperature from Fourier's law, we have Q conduction is equal to minus K into area perpendicular direction of heat flow into temperature gradient, that is T2 minus T1 by L. So be careful. Now we are solving the conduction heat transfer for this plate. So therefore I should take thermal conductivity of plate. Very, very important. Thermal conductivity of plate is given, which is 25. It is Q is already known. The rate of heat transfer is constant for steady state. So hence it is 235.74 is equal to minus K. K is 25 into area. So area perpendicular to the direction of heat flow. So area perpendicular direction of heat flow is this length into this length. This is 0.6, this is 1 into temperature difference at the top surface T2 is already known to me, which is 90 degrees Celsius. Bottom surface T1 is unknown. This is divided by over the length. Over what length we have a temperature gradient? Over a length of 0.025 meters. 0.025 meters. So therefore we get the bottom temperature as 235.74 into L by Ka. 0.025 divided by K is minus 25 into 0.6. So 90 minus answer will be 90.3929 degrees Celsius. So this is the complete solution for problem number 2, where in which the rate of heat transfer is 235 watts and the bottom surface temperature is 90.3929 degrees Celsius. Let me pause this video for a while so that people can copy it down. Later we'll solve the final problem of today's lecture. Now moving ahead for the final problem of today's lecture, that is problem number 3, states that the surface temperature of a thin plate located parallel to an air stream is 90 degrees Celsius. The phase stream velocity is 60 meters per second and air temperature is 10 degrees Celsius. The plate is 60 cm wide and 45 cm long in the direction of air flow. Assume that the transition Reynolds number as 4 into 10 to the power of 5 determine the average heat transfer coefficient in laminar and turbulent regions. The rate of heat transfer for the entire plate, considering both sides of the plate. If I list out the data given, that is for problem number 3, we have the data as we have a thin plate. So it is a thin plate, so therefore I will draw a very thin line for thickness. And in the direction of air stream, the length is 45 cm. Which is 0.45 meters and width is greater than length, it is 0.6 centimeter wide. Somewhat like this, we have a plate. And we have the length as 0.45 meters and we have the width as 0.6 meters. Now coming for other details, we have the surface temperature, that is wall temperature is 90 degrees Celsius. Phase stream velocity u is 60 meters per second. The air temperature T infinity is 10 degrees Celsius and he has given RE transition is 4 into 10 to the power of 4. Now as usual, let us evaluate the properties at film temperature. If I move for solution from page number 113, we know that the properties of working fluid. Here the working fluid is air stream, it is not steam, it is air stream. So therefore I should take the properties of dry air, properties of air is to be evaluated at film temperature, which is equal to average of wall times the fluid temperature by 2. So therefore film temperature for this problem is 90 plus 10 is 100, 100 by 2 is 50. Thank God for 50, we have all the values directly given in our data handbook. For air, from same page, that is page number 34, from page number 34 of our data handbook, list out the values, that is density, take it and list the values. We have the values of density at 50 degrees Celsius is 1.093 kg per meter cube. Absolute viscosity is 19.61 into 10 to the power of minus 6 Pascal second, and kinematic viscosity is 17.95 into 10 to the power of minus 6 meter square per second. At 50 degrees Celsius, thermal diffusivity of air is 25.722 into 10 to the power of minus 6 meter square per second. We have Prandtl number. Prandtl number is 0.698 and we have specific heat is 1005 joules per kgK, and finally we have thermal conductivity K as 0.02826 watt per meter Kelvin. So these are the properties of air at 50 degrees Celsius, which are noted down from page number 34. Now let us solve this problem. First, the approach should be different for this problem because he has given the transition Reynolds number as 4 into 10 to the power of 4. So therefore, up to what length the flow is laminar, I want to determine first. So therefore, using the Reynolds number, find the value of length x. So we know that Reynolds number is equal to rho u, x by mu I should take because I want to find up to what length the Reynolds number is less than 4 into 10 to the power of 5, that is for laminar flow. This equation is from page number 112. So transition Reynolds number is known, 4 into 10 to the power of 4 is equal to rho is 1.093. into velocity is 60 meters per second, into I want to know the length of laminar, divided by mu. Mu is 19.61 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So therefore laminar region that is XL, X laminar will be 4 into 10 to the power of 4 into 19.61 into 10 to the power of minus 6. This answer is divided by 1.093 into 60. So the answer is turning out to be 0.01196. So small. I think we have done a mistake somewhere. Oh, I'm sorry. The transition Reynolds number is 4 into 10 to the power of 5. I'm extremely sorry, it is 4 into 10 to the power of 5, kindly correct it. So therefore, here also it is 4 into 10 to the power of 5. So hence it will become 0.1196. So 0.1196 meters, now it is correct. So, turbulent will be Turbulent. Turbulent region, let's take it as x suffix t as overall length minus laminar region. So overall length is 0.45. So 0.45 minus, so this is the value of overall length, 0.45 minus 0.1196, which is nothing but 0.3304 meters. We have found out up to what length it is laminar and from what length it is turbulent. Now we should solve separately. He has asked us to find the average heat transfer coefficient for laminar and turbulent regions. Let me solve separately. In order to find heat transfer coefficient in laminar region, we know that the local heat transfer coefficient NUX is already known to us. That is, directly go for page number 113 for flow over flat plates. For constant wall temperature, for laminar flow, we have NUX is equal to 0.332 into REX to the power of 0.5 into Prandtl to the power of 1/3. Now, in order to find the convective heat transfer coefficient, that is for average convective heat transfer coefficient, first you find the local heat transfer coefficient in terms of X. Kindly make a note, find local heat transfer coefficient in terms of X. So here NUX is nothing but HX by K, which is equal to 0.332 into Reynolds number, is given by rho U X by mu whole to the power of 0.5 into PR power 1/3, because in PR we don't have length. Prandtl number is defined by mu Cp by K. So we don't have length in Prandtl number. We have length only in Nusselt number and Reynolds number. So now, therefore, Hx, so this is local, suffix X stands for local. So local convective heat transfer coefficient will become 0.332 into K into rho U by mu whole to the power of 0.5 into Prandtl power 1/3 into X to the power of 0.5 divided by X. So which is nothing but we have Hx is equal to 0.332 into K into rho U by mu whole to the power of 0.5 into Prandtl power 1/3 into X to the power of minus 0.5. I have taken this X to numerator. So now the formula for average heat transfer coefficient is given by H is equal to 1 by L integral over the length 0 to laminar flow is X laminar Hx dx. So this you people should remember the formula to find the average heat transfer coefficient. Now I can find the average heat transfer coefficient H. So H is equal to 1 by length for laminar region. Length for laminar region is LL. Length for laminar region is a general expression. Let me take it as a general expression. I can alter it as per our convenience. So let me write it as a general expression. This is general expression what we have. Now for laminar, length for laminar is XL. X laminar integral is from 0 to X laminar Hx is what we have, 0.332 into K into rho U by mu 4 to the power of 0.5
into pr power 1/3 into x to the power of minus 0.5 dx. Now we know all the values. If I substitute and solve, I will get h as, let me substitute and solve directly with the integration. So integration with respect to x is only for this term. X to the power of n is x to the power of n minus 1 by x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1. So therefore, x to the power of minus 0.5 plus 1 by minus 0.5 plus 1 will become x to the power of plus 0.5 divided by plus 0.5. Hence, if I substitute the limits and solve, I have 0.332 by laminar length is 0.1196 into k of air is 0.02826. Into density, let me write it as rho by mu. Mu by rho is kinematic viscosity. So therefore I can write it as 60 by kinematic viscosity, 17.95. Into 10 to the power of minus 6 whole to the power of 0.5. Into Prandtl. Prandtl number is 0.698 to the power of 1/3 into, we will get x to the power of 0.5 by 0.5. So upper limit is xl, lower limit is 0. So it is xl itself, that is 0.1196 to the power of 0.5 whole divided by 0.5. x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1 is the integration. So this is what I will get. So hence the answer for h laminar will be h lam, let me write, you know, to avoid confusion, h lam will be 0.332 by 0.1196 into 0.02826 into 60 by 17.95 into 10 to the power of minus 6 whole to the power of 0.5 into 0.698 to the power of 1/3. This is multiplied by 0.1196 divided by 0.1196 to the power of 0.5. So if I solve, I will get the answer as 87.997. The answer is 87.997 watt per meter square Kelvin. So we got the value of average heat transfer coefficient for laminar flow. So similarly, I should solve for turbulent flow. If I move for turbulent flow, we have local Nusselt number mu x is given by, for turbulent flow from the data and book, we have from page number 114, for fully turbulent from leading edge, we have mu x is equal to 0.0296 rex to the power of 0.8 PR power 0.33. This is from page number 114. Page number 114, equation 1.4.1. So if I refer page number 114 of our design data handbook, for fully turbulent from leading edge, we have for turbulent flow, the local Nusselt number is given by 0.0296. Reynolds power 0.8, Prandtl power 1/3. Now we can solve. 0.8. So now repeat the same procedure what we have done. So find local convective heat transfer in terms of x. So you get hx will be equal to 0.0296 into k into u by kinematic viscosity to the power of 0.8 into Prandtl power 1/3 into I get x to the power of 0.8 by x, that is x to the power of 0.8 minus 1, 0.8 minus 1 is minus 0.2, x to the power of minus 0.2. Now we know that h is equal to 1 by x term, x of turbulent integrates from 0 to x of turbulent hx dx. So therefore h of turbulent, h of turbulent will be equal to, I left out with 0.02996 by turbulent length is 0.3304 into k is 0.02826 into velocity is 60 by kinematic viscosity is 17.95 into 10 to the power of minus 6 4 to the power of 0.8, it is not 0.5, it is 0.8 into Prandtl is 0.698 to the power of 1/3. So integral of x to the power of minus 0.2 is minus 0.2 plus 1, that is 0.8 divided by 0.8 is what the integration result. So x turbulent is 0.3304 to the power of 0.8. So if I solve, I will get h turbulent as, so the answer is h turbulent is turning out to be, I can take it as 192 watt per meter square Kelvin. So this completes for laminar and turbulent flow. Now I can find the rate of heat transfer. Rate of heat transfer, this is the second question what he has asked. So rate of heat transfer will be, so rate of heat transfer considering both the sides, Q is equal to 2 times H laminar plus area differs rate, H laminar into area of laminar plus H turbulent into area of turbulent times the temperature difference. Let me write it as delta T. So therefore Q will become 2 times H laminar is, let me write it as 80H into area laminar. Area laminar is length into width. Length is 0.1196 into width is 0.6 plus H curve is 192 into turbulent length is 0.3304 into width is 0.6 times the temperature difference. Temperature difference is 90 minus 10, that is 80. So rate of heat transfer for this problem will be, the answer is 7100 watts. So this is the complete solution for problem number 3. So this completes our discussion on forced convection for flow over flat plate. From next lecture, I'll take up flow across cylinders and spheres. That's all for this lecture. Thank you all.